Hey guys, thanks for clicking on the video. SwitchCube Advanced Gaming here, and welcome back to the weekly show, Should You Buy, Episode 3. Today, we are covering a game that has been out for quite a while and on numerous platforms, and that game is Shovel Knight. For those of you who somehow don't know, Shovel Knight is the game. It's a 2D side-scroller platformer where you are a knight who wields a shovel, that's the name Shovel Knight, and you go through different levels fighting various king-themed bosses to fight an evil witch at the end of all the levels. Through your adventure, you can get different armor sets, different abilities, different items, etc. That's not all this game has to offer, though. The game does offer a very unique retro style of graphics, giving you a good pixelated graphic style, but not just to use to be lazy. It does work out very well. There's a lot of hidden humor within the game, a lot of different tricks and side quests you can do, and with the more recent updates, there are different storylines you can actually play. One of the various storylines you can play includes Plague of Shadows or Spectre of Torment, letting you play as different characters that you had faced throughout the game in playing their storylines leading up to the events of the first Shovel Knight game, if you will. There is another one that will be coming out this year, in fact, called King of Cards, where you play as King Knight, and you can see his storyline leading up to the events of Shovel of Hope, the normal storyline for Shovel Knight. All of these things combine together to give you a very wide range, probably in the range of 10 straight hours of gameplay per campaign is what I found, and you can get a lot of enjoyment for the small price tag that these usually have. You can buy Shovel Knight on really any platform. You can get Spectre of Torment on its own on the eShop, and the full treasure trove, which will include King of Cards for free, for somewhere in the range, I think it was $40, $30, somewhere in that area. This is, in fact, a definite buy. One of the first games I bought for my Switch, and I definitely recommend it for any player looking for a new game. So that's going to be it for this one, guys. Hope you liked this one. If you did, be sure to comment, like, and subscribe to the channel for more great Nintendo and Nintendo Switch-related content. It's going to be it for this one, guys. Bye-bye.